In November 2022, Government of Uganda through the Ministry of Education, Science and Sports and Uganda Intergovernmental Physical Transfers Program commenced construction of two seed secondary schools in Kagadi District to enhance quality secondary education in Uganda. The two seed secondary schools at Chitegwa Community Seed Secondary in Rutete Town Council, Buyaga West, and King Solomon Seed Secondary School in Kagadi Sub County, Buyaga East County, all valued at a cost of 3 billion shillings each. The project, estimated to take a period of 1 year and 8 months, is being undertaken by Banner Enterprises Limited at a cost of 6 million shillings from the Government of Uganda.
This school is a historical school in our area. We started it in 2007 to respond to the emergency that was emerging in our area. We lobbied the government using our networks to ensure it comes in and helps us. We are glad to NRM government for putting up these structures. Our request was considered. They have constructed 6 classroom blocks, a multi-purpose hall, a computer room, library, and the full-fledged laboratory. They are being constructed, and the worker, you can see, it is at where it appears now.
Mukiza is worried that they might miss the upcoming government opportunity of considering the school as a full-fledged government institution due to the delays being caused by the contractor.
We have hope that sooner than later, I think they will, the contractor will come and complete his work. But as you can see now, the site seems to be abandoned. The contractor is not here. The workers are not here. And our hope was that we expected our contractor to rhyme with the program of government, because we have information that the government is coming in free to own this school and recruit teachers, and we begin using our facilities for learning purposes.
However, Lilian Retehairo, the Kagadi Resident District Commissioner, who is also the Chief Government Monitor in the district, says the work being done at Chitegwa Community Seed Secondary School does not reflect the presidential pledge work. She says the materials being used are also not up to the standard to ensure the durability of the project.
But now when you see how they are doing things, the press is bushy, even the materials they are using, I've touched on these stones. Someone can get it with his hands or her hands and break it.
Retehairo ordered the contractor to return back to the project and ensure that the work is done in a standard way.
Yes, the way you see, when you see this bush, it is bushy, which means the site is abandoned. And we must see the value for money, because the money is too much. 3 billion. 3 billion, it is a lot of money. You can even construct a university. So we must see that value for money.
David Balaba, on behalf of Banner Enterprises, the contractor well on phone, said the company is working on fabrication of windows and furniture and that this work is done in Kampala.
Now, it is really, we wouldn't really call it abandoning, but those projects that the contract has two schools. We have a school in King Solomon and Kitegwa. Now, when we finished plastering, and we left there the team painting and fixing windows. For us, we now moved the team to go and again reinforce the Chitegwa people, because there was no big deal now. There, the glass are there, paint is there, the frames for windows are there. So we are modernizing the doors, the internal doors, because the internal doors are supposed to be, you're going to vanish this with the mahogany. Yeah? So now, those doors, after you take them from the factory, you take them to some people to fabricate them into pure mahogany. Because with them, they sell flash doors, but the flash doors they sell from the factory are not the pure mahogany.
Both seed secondary schools of Chitegwa and King Solomon were started by the communities in 2007 and have been managed by the parents for the past 16 years. These were contracted by the same company, Banner Enterprises, for construction at the cost of 6 billion shillings. The facilities at the new schools that are being constructed include a multi-purpose hall, 3 units of 2 classroom blocks, an administration block, a fully equipped 2-unit science block with science kits and chemical reagents, a library, an ICT block, and a 3-unit teacher's house, among others. Story compiled by Thomas Tumwebaze for the news.